Hey tech enthusiasts, welcome back to NotSoTechie, where we break down the latest and greatest in technology so everyone can understand. Today we've got something truly mind-blowing for you. Ever thought about how the cement used to build your home could turn it into a huge battery? Crazy, right? But it's actually happening. Before we start talking about this amazing innovation, please remember to subscribe and hit the bell icon to stay updated on our future tech updates. Let's get started. Imagine a future where the very walls of your house could power your devices. Sounds like science fiction? Well, it's closer to reality than you might think. Let's take a closer look at how concrete is being turned into a giant battery. Concrete as a battery. The experiment. Concrete is used a lot in construction all over the world, and it could also be used to generate electricity for our homes with a few changes. In Cambridge, Massachusetts, cylinders of black concrete are sitting on a laboratory bench surrounded by liquid and cables. At first glance, they appear inactive. When Damian Stefaniuk flips a switch, the LED that is connected to the engineered rock blocks lights up and starts flickering. At first, Stefaniuk wasn't sure about the LED lighting up. They thought that maybe the external power source was still connected, which would explain why the LED turned on. So, what's causing all this excitement? This seemingly unassuming dark block of concrete might be the future solution for storing energy. Renewable energy storage challenges. Most renewable energy sources offer the potential for continuous clean energy from the sun, wind, and sea. But the sun doesn't always shine, the wind doesn't always blow, and calm waters don't always produce enough energy. This intermittency is a big challenge in our energy-dependent society. This implies that we need a way to store that energy using batteries. However, batteries need materials like lithium, which are not plentiful enough to keep up with the increasing demand as we move towards renewable energy. Plus, lithium mining has its own environmental downsides. There are only 101 lithium mines in the world. Experts doubt if these mines can meet the growing demand. Experts warn that lithium mining requires a lot of energy and water, which cancels out the environmental benefits of switching to renewable energy sources. Additionally, the extraction process for lithium can result in harmful chemicals leaking into nearby water sources. Despite the discovery of new lithium reserves, the limited availability, heavy reliance on a few mines worldwide, and harmful environmental effects of lithium have led to the search for alternative battery materials. So, what's the solution? This is when we heard the good news from Professors Franz Josef Ohm, Admir Masik, Damian Stefaniuk, and team at Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT. They have developed a method to produce a supercapacitor using inexpensive materials such as water, cement, and carbon black. Are you ready to see how researchers achieved this? Keep watching. The role of supercapacitors. Supercapacitors are excellent at energy storage, but they have differences compared to batteries. They can be charged much faster than lithium-ion batteries and do not degrade as quickly in performance. But supercapacitors are not suitable for devices like phones, laptops, or electric cars because they release stored power quickly instead of providing a steady and prolonged energy supply. Stefaniuk believes that carbon cement supercapacitors could have a big impact on efforts to reduce carbon emissions in the global economy. He states that if the technology can be scaled up, it could help solve the problem of storing renewable energy. Future applications of carbon cement supercapacitors. The team at MIT and Harvard University's WIS Institute for Biologically Inspired Engineering are exploring different uses for their supercapacitors. Imagine roads that store solar energy and wirelessly recharge electric cars as they drive. Or energy storing building foundations. Yeah, these ideas are awesome, aren't they? But it's still in early days. Solid supercapacitors can currently store nearly 300 watt-hours per cubic meter. This is enough energy to power a 10-watt LED light bulb for 30 hours. Stefaniuk explained that even though the power output of this new system may seem lower compared to regular batteries, using a foundation with 30, 40 cubic meters of concrete could still generate enough energy to meet a house's needs. Concrete is widely used globally, so it can be a competitive and useful choice for energy storage. So, how does concrete generate energy, you might wonder? Let's take a closer look at how they achieve it. The secret lies in the high conductivity of carbon black. Mixing carbon black with cement and water creates a conductive concrete with interconnected materials. it can store charge rapidly, making it perfect for renewable energy storage. Ohm's team started with small 1-volt supercapacitors and connected them to power a 3-volt LED. Now they're developing larger versions, including a 12-volt supercapacitor that can power a handheld gaming device. Imagine the possibilities. One of their ambitious goals is to build a 45 cubic meter supercapacitor that can store about 10 kilowatt hours of energy, which is enough to power a house for a day. This could transform how we store and use energy in our homes. Capacitors consist of two conductive plates separated by a membrane. In this scenario, both plates are made of carbon black cement soaked in an electrolyte salt called potassium chloride. Applying an electric current to the salt-soaked plates caused the positively charged plates to attract negatively charged ions from potassium chloride. The membrane prevented the exchange of charged ions between the plates, resulting in the creation of an electric field. Supercapacitors can quickly store a lot of charge, which could be useful for storing extra energy from sources like wind and solar power. This could help alleviate strain on the grid during periods when there is no wind or sunlight available. For example, consider an off-grid house that depends on solar panels for electricity. This system uses solar power during the day and uses stored energy in the foundations at night, as Stefaniuk explained. However, these supercapacitors do have drawbacks as well. Challenges and environmental considerations. Supercapacitors release power quickly, so they're not ideal for providing a consistent output throughout the day. The team is working on improving their carbon cement solution, but they're not sharing details yet. They'll wait until they finish testing and publish their findings. Other issues might need to be considered too, like adding more carbon black to the supercapacitor can boost its energy storage, but it might also make the concrete weaker. The study authors recommend carefully balancing the amount of carbon black used in applications that need both structural support and energy storage. Although carbon cement supercapacitors may lessen our dependence on lithium, they also have their own environmental consequences. The production of cement is responsible for 5-8% of worldwide carbon dioxide emissions. The carbon cement needed for the supercapacitors must be newly produced, rather than being integrated into existing structures. Despite these challenges, there's a lot of optimism. Michael Short from Teesside University sees huge potential in using the built environment for energy storage. He asserts that the research presents various opportunities for using the built environment as a form of energy storage. Short is hopeful about the easy access to materials and the uncomplicated manufacturing process, suggesting that we should continue to investigate this approach as a useful tool in achieving a cleaner and more sustainable future. Transitioning new discoveries from small-scale experiments to larger productions can be challenging. Manufacturing complexities, resource limitations, and underlying scientific principles can hinder the process. What works for a product in a small market might not work in a bigger market. Short suggests that there could be a solution to the issue of harmful cement for the environment. His colleagues at Teesside University are developing a sustainable alternative using waste materials from the steel and chemical sectors. New types of cement and concrete show that buildings and infrastructure will be important for clean energy in the future. Wow, what an incredible journey into the future of energy storage. Concrete that powers our homes, truly remarkable. If you like learning about advanced technology, please give us a thumbs up, share this video with your friends, and remember to subscribe to Not So Techie for more exciting tech updates. Let us know in the comments what you think about this groundbreaking innovation. Until next time, stay curious and keep exploring the fascinating world of technology. See you soon.